Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for coming out today and braving the wind chill to be out here. My name is Tamika Walker Kelly, and I am from Cumberland County. I am here before you because I am proud to be an elementary music teacher. I am currently in my 11th year of teaching, and each year brings its own kinds of successes and challenges. However, this year the challenge is not anything inside my classroom. The challenge is if I will have a classroom at all. You will hear many people call my fellow colleagues specialists, and indeed, in fact, they are correct. We are the teachers who cultivate creativity, collaboration, and critical thinking skills beyond the general classroom. We turn noise into music, mistakes into masterpieces, and movement into art. My friends, as parents and guardians, we send our kids to school to have a full educational experience. And that cannot happen if there are no arts, physical education, or world languages in our public schools.
That's right.
We have been presented a false choice, having to choose between smaller class sizes or a complete curriculum that is supposed to be guaranteed by the state. As a parent first and a teacher second, my child and all of our children deserve to have both. We have done our part in contacting the General Assembly. We've been emailing, we've been calling, we've been having conversations. Now we want action.
Action!
We want an end to the class size chaos because our specialists are the heartbeat of a school.
Yes.
We see every child in a school building. We watch them grow and develop their gifts and their talents. We want an end to the class size chaos because our schools deserve stability in providing the best educational experience for children with no unfunded mandates. We want an end to the class size chaos because our students, these kids right here, deserve every resource to experience success, not only in math and reading, but through music and drama, art, dance, and through the power of words. We often cheer the powerhouse singers and the star athletes or the brilliant painters that showcase the greatness that can come from North Carolina. But we must not let our lawmakers forget that the foundation of them all happens in an elementary school. From the first school play, the first screechy notes of a recorder, to that very first three-point shot on the court. Lawmakers, our students can no longer wait on your inaction. Yeah. Fix the class size chaos. Yeah. Our students are counting on you. Thank you.